Hello and welcome everyone, Lanhart here with part 10 of the Bretonnia Let's Play. For Total Warhammer, we continue where we left things off last time. I've gone through and named all the units in Shilfroy's army here. This course is an hour special, so sit back and relax and enjoy the road ahead. So, Shilfroy the Devoted. Now, some of you are saying you're calling for his resignation, being stripped of command for sacking a settlement, but I believe actually, despite it being an unchivalrous action against the scum and filth of the north, of Varg and Scaling, I think it is fine, and he can atone by crushing their armies in the field of battle in the name of the lady. So, yes. The other reason I don't want to swap him, a lot of you are calling swap him for Alberic, then you start leveling him up. A lot of you actually suggested for now, actually, bring Alberic into Marienburg and actually upgrade his, is it like Yield of the Sea or something like that? It's along his blue line. It's only a few ones in, so you don't have to waste too many on that. But plop him in Marienburg and, watch the money pour in. Is the plan there. You guys also saying I need to put up garrisons and defense, especially in Estalia, because if beastmen spawn in, I'm going to be in trouble, so we'll get that to that in a moment. We're just going to go through the names of these units here, and then we're going to auto-resolve this battle, the Longship Graveyard. So we've got the Cleavers of Caron, the Bastogne Regulars, the Peasants Templar, the Elderberry Swords, Boars of the Lion, the Bastions of the North, the Merchant Guard, the Shields of Padavon, Shields of the Realm, the Shrubbery Shooters, Men in Tights, Arthur's Arrows, we already had the Charges of Caron, and the Peasant Preservers. We now have the Northern Crusaders, Crusaders of the Lady, and the Young Guard. Now, the army that I haven't named units for is the Fey Enchantress Army, because I was looking through, and maybe I just didn't see too many, but I didn't see too many names just for Foot Knights or Battle Pilgrims. Not even sure if I saw any for Grail Guardians. And also, this isn't a full army, and I'm going to name my armies once they get to full one. So she could well be named next episode if we get... She needs three more units of cavalry, and then she's done. Her army is ready to go. Also, in terms of the quest battles, I know you guys are still waiting for them. I just haven't had a chance to get around to doing Alberic or the Fey Enchantress' quest battles yet. I'm hoping I might get a chance this weekend or early next week. But I'll keep you guys updated, and again, I will mention it in these videos, these series, when those quest battle videos come out. So do stay tuned for that. Anyway, let's finish this. Hopefully we won't lose any of those units I've just named. No, thankfully we didn't. And we could sack it for some chivalry. We do kind of need some money to keep on going, but I am going to raise it this time. We're getting plenty of money. Hates chaos. Good, good. And the Court Jester reduces it. That's for Percival. Tollkeeper tax rate increase. My reputation precedes me. Oh, we can't get into the sea this turn. No. We're going to take attrition. I think it's time we brought them back then for a smidge. A bit of a reprieve. Although we can use them to strike the Ice Drake Fjord and Pack Ice Bay. Although, yeah, Pack Ice Bay is pretty open. Blessings. Now we started to raise these, we can start doing some more permanent damage. We are just gaining chivalry like crazy. A lot of you guys are saying you gained up to like 2 or 3 or even 4k chivalry just as you were going along, but that didn't, you know, you weren't able to go off your final Errantry War battle because you needed to level up more. And I kind of like that, that you have the ultimate objective, you know, potentially quite early on, within the first 100 turns easily. But you can't necessarily get to it because there's lots of other things going on. So I kind of like that. So we'll continue to raid up here. Well, sack them. I think we possibly will do some raiding at some point. Not up here, but possibly against the Wood Elves. I was trying that out in a Borderlow campaign. And you can earn quite a bit from that. And it's only like minus 2 chivalry a turn. I don't think, actually, at this point, you shouldn't be afraid of losing chivalry or doing non-chivalrous acts. If you need to. And someone too, if you're still going, oh, Lionheart, you really have to kill the Wood Elves, you have to go after them, what are they doing? Well, seeing as we have the Forest Edge Decree, so it is kind of a potential target that we can go for, I'd like to go for that. And I'd like to see the Oak of Ages burn, and, you know, I don't, potentially, you know, having some rampaging tree men and tree kin on your border, that doesn't sound very good for the peasants. You guys were also saying that the water pumps, each of your regions can sustain an extra peasant unit, which is quite useful. Harbormaster bribes, that's also quite good to go for. It does cost us a fair little bit and a bit of chivalry, but that is fine. Once we're done with the Ruinous Powers one, depending on if Beastmen have turned up by then or if we're going to go after the Wood Elves, we'll go for one of those or we'll just focus on economy from there. We're nearly done with everything else anyway. We probably should actually look at getting the unification of Bretonnia just because that would help relations with Dwarves and Empire. And that's not a bad thing. We've still got the Green Knight to use, and I think we'll use it against the Scaling, but I think we'll definitely summon him for when we decide to start attacking Durthu and the other Wood Elves in there. So that's the plan with that. Feyentrance is going to look after Helmgart for a few turns. She needs to get some cavalry when possible. We're going to move on into Marienburg. I can't bring Alberic in just yet. He is... four turns away from being placed. But Marienburg should hold for one turn until we can get Luan in here. We need to pop Tim L'Enchantress back in, and we'll bring Shilfroy back from the north. Do we give you Warhorses and Pegasus now? We could do. Having you as solid flyers might be quite nice. But again, I quite like the idea that you were dismounted on foot powerhouses. Feel free to weigh on this. I'm going to continue making them powerhouses for now, but feel free if you think we should start getting them mounted and flying, especially. We already have the Royal Pegasus for Shilfroy, so maybe we could just have the whole crew, but he's going to go towards his Hippogriff soon. That's another reason why I don't want to swap him out for Alberic. Yes, Alberic is the Legendary Lord. It would be nice to have all three on the field and leading armies and what have you at the moment, but Shilfroy is better and stronger. Let's just go down to Luan because that tax one, I want to apply that. Tax plus 12%, that's rather nice. Have we got anything we can give to old Sir Gawain? No, but maybe some weapons. Sword of Anti-Heroes, that will work nicely. And the Grail Shield. Huzzah. Virtue of the Ideal. Cracking. No one's got any... Shieldfroy should probably have some... I guess he's got a negative one by now, hasn't he? Procrastinator. Really? Really? We'll have to get you home praying. You guys are also saying get rid of the military buildings in Koron. And build it up as a fortress and a kind of staging ground to go out forward. Also, get your buildings in there to your legendary buildings. So you want to get it up, built up. To be fair, Corona actually works as quite a nice economic hub, although there's no amazing buildings you can get. But I'm probably going to put farms and industry in there because Corona's main building line gives income from all buildings plus 45%, all regions in this province, and income from all buildings in adjacent provinces. So we kind of want to, you know, increase that as much as we can. That will certainly help. We've got the Realm of Chivalry, construction costs for next turn. Where else are we going to be building? We're going to be building down here in Estalia. So we should swap that over to construction. Yeah, Realm of Chivalry. We'll build up the defences, yes, at Magritta first. And then we'll try and upgrade these guys. They just cost a lot. Just get them to tier 3, then they'll have walls. Yes, then we could put Garrus in them as well if we want to. We probably need to put up our farms as well. We've got the vineyard there. Actually, we'd have to destroy the vineyard to get the fields up to maximum before we could ever use them, thinking about it. Which, yeah, we might need to tweak some bits around there. Telia still holding out. We can upgrade the farm here, or we could upgrade the brine pits. Brine Mine. got the Tower of the Feyenchantress. That, we want to upgrade that so we can get her Grail Guardians. And that's all we'll be getting from here. Let's upgrade the farm. Also, in terms of where we're getting our military production, it's going to be Bastogne and Artois. Although we need to get the woodworker and that in there for archers and what have you. That's fine. We need to tweak that around in a bit. But yeah, definitely Bastogne because of the Mastersmith's Forge. And yeah, I don't know. You guys are trolling me or maybe one or two people are genuinely confused about this. But the Warhorse Breeder Stables and things like that, they are region specific. They are never been faction wide. There is a mod that makes those faction wide. But that is that would make them pretty OP. One or two people did say they stack, though, even if you're not in the same province. Were saying they were stacking, they were getting plus 9 for their knights, even though they weren't in all the same region. So I don't know what's happening there. Maybe there's some other bonus going on, or some other trainer affecting that, quite honestly. I mean, I guess we can try it out by building more horse stables there, but I was always under the impression that they were regional, as many of you confirmed. Some of you suggesting that people are just trolling me. I don't know. I'm at your mercy. I'm at your mercy. So that's all we need to do this turn. Let's end it. But that is the plan of what we're up to with everything. So Bastogne and Artois will be my unit production centres because they've got the best ones there for knights, swordsmen, spearmen, archers between all of them. Oh, they're actually pulling back a smidge. Okay, that works.
Priestess of the Lady, I have seen your heart. Your behest?
Champion of the Lady. The Lion.
I think we're going to try and get Sir Gawain, actually, to...
My blade is ready.
Huzzah, success. Nicely done, dude. Yeah, we'll give you Deadly Blade for now. Actually, where was... Didn't I have a paladin, or was he my paladin wandering about?
Defender of the Week.
Defender of the Week. Yes, the other ones are all knights. So, well, I might actually, I've now put that point into your ability because we're going to have you in the army for now, but I might also buff this lot up as well for you rather than go full attack.
You seek counsel?
We've got 10k sitting here. Right, they've pulled back a little bit. Assume it's because they're going after Shilfroy and we need to bring him back because he is getting obliterated. In fact, he could be intercepted, which would be a bit troublesome, so we should probably get Luan to potentially chase him down.
My journey begins.
I will be rewarded.
For glory!
They want to fight us on there, we'll have to auto-resolve it. And we'll see how that goes. Right, that's not super important right now. You guys are saying build defenses. Well, Corona is a special building tree where it gets its own garrison troops just from its main building, so it doesn't have a defensive line of buildings. Oh, it's also got we got the clay pit there. But yeah, we want to go income. We're also upgrading that main building. So I'm going to clay pit it because that doesn't require any else, and we'll leave that one open to go for the windmill. Build that up for economy. So we need those top two slots have got to be left for the two legendary buildings, which we are upgrading to get to tier 4, and then we can go further up from there, which is all nice. Plus 2 cavalry unit recruits all characters. Yeah, so that's that possibly... Things like that can stack and give you more.
Strength and honor.
Artois, we could upgrade you, but it's not super important right now. At least that's giving us extra recruitment on those. In fact, let's just check that. If we move her here... Yeah, see, they've all got rank 6 on those. How's that? How are they rank 6 already? Because that only adds plus 3. Have I already got something that's adding extra? Or has she got something that's giving her better recruitment cost? Empire crossbowmen and spearmen recruits. That's no good to us. Why do we even have that? maybe it's something Lewin has. Has he got like a faction-wide buff? Why are they tier 6? Not quite sure, to be honest. Sure one of you guys will know why. But yes, she can now recruit those. In fact, is Helmgart going to rebel this time? No, it's not. So let's get your final units of cavalry in here. Questing knights, I kind of feel, would be a good one for her to have. The anti-infantry as well, they're armoured. Along with the Grail Guardian, so 2 turns for those. It's going to hit the old income a little bit, but we can now come down here. We can upgrade the walls. Which one's going to be hit first? Well, Tabara is on the eastern flank, so let's get that covered first. That'll give us walls at least, then we can build a garrison. But at least with walls, it's going to stop any immediate beastman incursion.
Smite them.
Smite them. We'll leave that for now. The rest of the money, I don't think we can spend it on anything just yet. We need to upgrade Baston. Pock Shelter. I think you guys are also saying getting the Apothecary as well, because then you just turned Koron into a really solid defensive unit replenishment hub from raiding north. I think we'll be raiding north for a very, very long time. That's fine, you're up there. Right, end the turn. And our Ruinous Powers decree will be done, so that'll lessen the attrition from just being in Chaos Corruption. Okay, they've poured onto land. That's fine. Ruinous Power Decree. Right, right, right. Luan, can you get him? Ah, next turn. To glory. We can't get Alberic for two more turns, but then we can start really pumping up Marienburg. Income is good right now. It's going to drop in a bit. Right. Oh, that can upgrade as well. Sweet, we had enough for that. Right, now that's all done, so the walls will be fine when the next Beastmen wave comes on in. Carcassonne, we should probably, yeah, once we upgrade that, get some walls in you as well. What are we going to go for next? Not going to go for Beastmen or anything. We're going to go for Unification of Bretonnia first, then we'll go for Economics. One more turn and then you're good to go. There are some Beastmen over here, the Jagged Horn Tribe. Go after you over there. And then, yeah, it looks like we're going to probably maybe even bring the Fae Enchantress to go crusading in the north. She does have a very crusadery type army, so. They've pulled back there. I'd like to think the auto-resolve would be still in our favour for Shilfroy, but you need to come back and replenish. Actually, that probably isn't the worst thing in the world to build. That's suggesting that Pox Shelter. Yes. Right, because that is our staging ground. We do want every extra bit of replenishment that we can get. Well, when it upgrades, we'll have a slot through. We'll have that one, clay pit, industry. So we won't be able to have it with all of the bits in there. Mm. What about Marienburg? Will we have a free slot at Marienburg? You don't have any other special bits. We want walls in there. The fields, that. Industry walls, not enough to have it there, unless I forego one of these bits. I guess it's clay pit over everything else, really, isn't it? We need to look at what we need right now. Do we really need a little bit more income, or can we? Actually, we could build. Is it only tier 3? It's only a tier 3 anyway, so actually, it can go in a Longueuil, which will still help the region. So once the water wheel's improved next turn, we can set that farm to upgrade, and we can actually destroy the water wheel. Yeah, it'll go in there. There we go. Problem solved. Good to know that my demise is certain, I guess. Got something to do. Right, raiding. Aggressor for Tim L'Enchantresse. Control for every concurrent war with a neighbouring faction. Okay. Income from all buildings. Armor trait gained. Okay. That's really useful for where you currently are.
My deeds are legend.
Any traits you can have? Nope.
Inspires. I am the blood of Shin.
Tim, have you got all your bit? No, you haven't got that. Comet of Cassandora, yeah, let's throw that in there. Devoted of the Goddess. Skill selections have been made. I mean, this character highly effective spellcaster. Ooh. So, what does that mean, though? Devoted of the Goddess. What does that do? Devoted of the Goddess. I don't know. You're boring, apparently. But what does it do? It doesn't say. Skill selections have made this character highly effective. Just less chance to miscast? I don't know. More power preserve? Not a clue. We'll fight this one. Trim pendant, yeah, we'll pop it on. Dim, let's fight! And break! He's scaling. Fools! Dare enter the land of Luan Lienker. Start deployment, that's enough of a good one. Alright, so you've got to deal with those chariots. Sorceress! A knight to say. Nee. We're all anti-large. Infantry like so, archers behind, like so, trebuchets in the center, Luan, Beaquis. I believe is this the first battle we've had with Beaquis? I'm not sure. When we fought, possibly. You hold the center, and Gawain, you look after the right flank, and you stand. There we go, leading the men. Many of you say he's got a very Baratheon feel to him. I like it. I like it. Fix his knights. Right. Grail knights! It's not a favourable position for us, to be honest. Uphill from the start. Kind of wondering if actually maybe you want to just pull back a little bit. Doesn't really do too much for us. They're still downhill to us, but we can hold. Start and see if they move to us. Yeah, there we go. We're saying my trebuchets will kick in any second. Pegasus Knights! At once! Knights of the realm! Have my cav over here so we can send them in against the marauders, although, well, I say that actually. We probably shouldn't focus too much on the marauders. We need the archers to focus on them. I'm just gonna do that. Grab two of the archers over like so. One of the archers over here. You guys like so. I am ready. They spotted us. Let's see how we deal.
I see much.
Clear. Pass that too far back. Damn. Cool down. Oh dear. Missed. Come down this way, this way, this way. Blast. Luan. Break them. Over there. Oh, they got behind us. That's not cool, guys. Let's get the cavalry into the main line instead. What do you bid? Immediately! Ride them down! Swiftly! We obey! Doing our duty! Battle ready! Broken one of my trebuchets already, damn it! Peasant woman! As you say, moving a base! Move cavalry, move!
Field trebuchet! Hand and arms! Yes, Miller!
Oh, cavalry, I'm sorry, over here.
It shall be done.
Oh, Sword of Coron. Nice. That's useful. In come the cavalry charges, beautiful. They are anti-large, to be fair. We probably need to swap his out, him to get a few more anti-infantry units in there. Would be ideal. Good. I didn't catch those guys.
All men, die, fiends. King Luen Leonker.
Oh yeah, he's break massive break on his morale. There we go.
Ready for orders.
Just have to hold until they break. Problem with facing the Norse is they have so much ranged cavalry. It's really hard trying to use my own cavalry against them because they're just able to envelop them. I'm not able to effectively get the flanking in. But we haven't lost a whole unit anywhere, so that's all good. It has worked. Let's just fast forward so we can kill as many of them as possible. I like his Sword of Coron Hex, that's good. We need to have him more in the front line, but I stopped those units flanking in just by tying them all up with him, so he proved his worth. Holding up, what, 3 or 4 units that would have otherwise really pressured my left flank. So, yeah, need to be able to... Got to get into better cavalry management. I did it with my Huns Let's Play. I can do it now. The infantry just acting as holding units along the front line. A close victory. Okay. Alright, alright, alright. 183, 196, 132, 89. Yeah, reasonable. Luan getting 114. It's all good. Kill them. Slay them all. I skipped through those bits at the end, didn't I? A bit too quick.
The lady and my right.
Kill them. Oh no! We lose these knights of the realm. Or did I not name these guys? I didn't name those guys. Okay, well that's kind of okay, but still. Damn. Well, to be fair, I now that I've got the knights of the realm, probably need to replace them with some anti-infantry as well, because those guys are all anti-large. Gained the legend trait. Gained by winning more than 90% of battles. Weapon strength 20, unbreakable, melee attack, chivalry. Some insane traits to get. Love it. Engines of War, then Stand Your Ground next time. So yeah, we have lost that unit, but you guys are all anti-large. These are Grail Knights, okay. So you're up from... The ones up from Knights of the Realm. Kind of feeling like I might get rid of these, this unit of Knights of the Realm here, and get two anti-infantry ones, cavalry units. I think that might serve better. Because we've already got the Knights of St. Nee and the Royal Lancers. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that, so I'm going to just merge you two. Bye-bye to you. We can't do anything on global. Right, where are we recruiting our cav these days? It's over here. Let's force march you this way, Lorn. Because we've got questing knights. I think I might put in questing knights because they're pretty solid. Right, there is going to be a rebellion. We've got beastmen also coming through here. There is going to be a rebellion at Helmgart, so I'm gonna face the rebellion down. It's going to rebel in, let's see, in three turns, unless I actually move her out, so let's keep her there. Should do it in, oh, it's still three turns. Oh yeah, because it calls 99, yep.
You seek the lady?
Are you the only ones from that tribe? You're all with all these guys, I might just attack you and try out my new units. I haven't had a chance to try them out, really. It's a small army. Sure, we could deal. Let's just move down here and check everything else. We could upgrade you, Magritta, as well. Probably wouldn't hurt. Go on then. We were going to do some stuff over here, though, weren't we? Ah, yes, I need a little bit more money to do that. Okay, we're not going to upgrade Magritta because I want my replenishment plan. No, can't. Oh, no. Ooh, that was close. Nearly cancelled the wall on its last. On its last turn. Right. Upgrade that. Don't need the windmill anymore. Build the windmill there. Upgrade the pottery.
King Louis and Leoncoeur.
Seeing as we're fighting with you at the moment, keep buffing that. And yeah.
Who wishes the grave?
Declare war.
Holy wrath. Winds rise.
And I want to fight this because I want to take a look at all the units I've got here. We're also getting a bit of reinforcement. I'm going to use my Blessed Field Trebuchet. Got the Grail Relinquary. Grail Guardians. Got a really, really tasty army here. Mm-mm-mm. Beautiful. Right. You were going to gamble with that. What's she got? She's got Chalice of Potions. Causes large magical damage, large strike out. Ooh. Favor of the Fae. Plus 58 melee attack. Kind of, why so much forest? Why? Gotta see what I'm doing. Thankfully we can remove as we go through. Let's take a look at some of these. Let's get everyone formed up, then we'll take a look at everyone. I'm trying to think of my formation here.
Battle pilgrims! We serve the king.
That's fine, right. Foot squires. There, battle pilgrims, you hold the right. With a halberd unit on each flank.
Stay in post. Go in your bed. There's a bowman.
Grail Relinquary has icon of devotion, leadership, so it helps strengthen up. Leadership to those around it. It has its own frenzy ability, magical aura. It has blessing of the lady. I think do all of my units? No, it's just that one actually already has a blessing of the lady. Nice. Someone was asking, like, do blessings of the lady stack if they've already got it, and then the whole army gets it, or do they not get it? Oh, didn't mean to group all them. Cavalry today. I'm gonna put you on the right flank. And Blessed Field Trebuchet. Okay, I can see like the little blessings there. Anyway, let's take a look at these units. We have the Foot Squires at the front. Fantastic haircut there, sir. Fantastic. Do let me know the name of your barber, so I can avoid it. Have the battle pilgrims over here. Also, yeah, don't let me know who did your hair either. A little tuft at the front and... ooh. Like the hoods, though. Hoods are looking good. Hoods are looking good. Where's that growl link creep? There he is. Should call him Patsy. Love it. Dead knight. Skeleton and all dressed up, holding a chalice and a lance, all strapped to him. Just flopping about. Just love he's tied round. That's brilliant. And they're just carrying him around. You look so pleased that you've got this job. Candles on his horse's head. Metal frame. Bells as his tail. And a big old bell underneath him. That is cracking. I love it. Absolutely love it. Right, we're just going to take a look at our cavalry. Oh, we'll take a look at the Fate Enchantress herself. So these are our questing knights. They've got all they need, all their pack, all their, I guess, tomes. Sort of those books are going to get wet. All the stuff in their drawers, I guess. There are seals. They've got a sword and shield ready at their side, but they're wielding great swords. I mean, like cleaving a path. I love it. And then, of course, the best of those questing knights become these guys, Grail Guardians. Flaming sword, true of heart, take up thy sword and shield, and thy holy hand grenade of Antioch. right. Let's take a look at the... Where have I even put the Fae Enchantress? I don't think I placed her. There we go. Hovering, glowing. She's got some light emitting from around her. And there we go. Like lightning from our eyes, it looks like. Just floating around. What are you doing? Cool. And she's also got her weakening of the wood. So, the games begin! They are coming. Oh, here we go. Yeah, so holy water. Oh, it's actually hit some of them that were hidden. Nice. Got to make it through the trees, though. Not ideal. Oh, Saigal's going to have a go now. Lob it. Oh, that trebuchet shot's going to hit. Nice. Squires! I'm actually going to move my army this way a smidge, although we're going to leave the trebuchet where it is. Oh, you guys can go up there, right. Yeah, you guys get up the hill. Moving forward because... go, go, go. Go, go, go. Archers hold back. Battle pilgrims. Oh, Minotaur's getting stuck in there. Trying to slow him down a bit. Squires. Bring him down, bring him down, bring him down. Get a nice rear charge in here in a minute. Getting messy with the Minotaurs. Grail Relinquary's in here. Send him in. Cavalry! Charge! Yay! Slow motion for this. They don't have wedge formation. None of them. Interesting. We lost the peasant bowman unit. Watch these guys get their charge in. Because this should be glorious. Oh, yeah, they don't have wedge because they're not shock cavalry. melee cav with that. Great swords there. Lovely. That looked beautiful. What's these guys here, where they're clashing on into. Great old guardians. They're going in for the Saigor. They know their target. Gonna try and lob a rock at them. No, he stopped. And they've made it to him, and they will fight him now. Hey, where's the best spot to pop this? Yeah, I think around about here. Woo! Like a massive comet of Cassandora. Grow Relinquary. Get him. Go. Go, Patsy. How's my cavalry doing? Oh, Pullman, you're way out of there. Here come the cavalry. Get them, squires. Those archers as well. Trying to take down this beastman lord. Broken all those guys. No, Patsy the Grail Relinquary is going down. Get off him. There we go. Yeah, knock him about. You are very low on health, sir. Very, very low on health. I feel he's not going to like getting mobbed by everyone. No, he's not. Oh no, my blessed field trebuchet got taken out. I didn't even see that. Someone's going to have commented on that. Probably have lost it. The morale's going though. There we go. Ah, that's a shame. Sorry, blessed field trebuchet. Close victory. Yeah, we lost a fair few there, actually. Fair few. Didn't actually get too many kills. The forest wasn't the best place for it. Saigor, Minotaur's just getting so much. Ah, it survived though, that's good. They suffered too many. Grail Relinquary still alive. Okay. They have fallen. You seek prophecy. Thankfully, the trebuchet stayed, so that's all good. Oh yeah, the whole we've got a few turns here. She needs to replenish up pretty quickly, otherwise we're going to be in trouble at Helmgart. In fact, we could pop her in to Helmgart next turn. I should have kept her in normal stance actually, so I could recruit. That is fine. She has leveled up. Ah, she can get her mount, Sylvaron, unicorn. I like her floating around. Worshippers of the Grail, Battle Pilgrims and Grail Relinquary units. Probably, but she's AI gave her basic training buffs. I'd rather give the buff for the Worshippers of the Grail, seeing as that's what I want to spec her army out with. Power Familiar. Yeah, we'll go for some spells with her, I guess. I'm not actually too bothered about using her spells. Root Marcher, actually. We need to give her that, because she doesn't have that yet. And that's a rather useful skill, actually, to have. So, yeah. Make sure you've got that one. Luwin's over there. Chilfroy is... You come back to Koron. Okay, right, let's end that turn. Cover, rebuild. Let them hunt new hunting grounds, unit experience for cavalry unit recruits. But the recruitment cost is plus 50 for cavalry units or familiar hunting grounds. Charge bonus for cavalry units and upkeep. That's 10 turns. That's 10 turns as well. Unique experience. I guess I'm going to recruit some new ones with Luan. Luan Lienker. And more expensive would be nice rather than temporary charge bonus, because the unique experience is forever. Charge bonus is for 10 turns. Yeah, and upkeep. No, let them hunt. Alberic is ready. Cool. We're going to bring Alberic in then. Marienburg. But we'll give him an army eventually. Don't worry, guys. He won't just be sat here forever. We'll replace him with someone else that can just... Lord of the Sea or whatever it is. Yield of the Sea. Actually, he's not being specced out towards that. That's plus 50 from that. And I believe... Is that specific to him? You have... 10th share, but that's only 15%. Whereas yours can get a bit ridiculous, mate. Plus 150%. I assume it's just for him. Well, I can check with Shilfroy, can't I? I can see what Shilfroy has. Yeah. And yeah. So yeah, that's why we want to use Albrick. It's part of his kind of abilities, his own special one. We are going to need to build him up then, actually. So maybe I should have popped him. Maybe we could pop him over into swap armies with Shilfroy then for a bit, just to get him a couple of levels. Do need to do that. You will just gain levels by sitting there, but I want to deal with that. Right, there's going to be a rebellion in 2 turns' time. We can get to Helmgart. It's probably actually enough to leave us here. That's 4 turns for most of these guys, but still. Good thing we've actually got that casualty replenishment rate bonus there. Smidge of it, anyway. Is there anything else that increases replenishment? No, that's fine. We do want to upgrade Helmgart, though, but not yet. So what are we going to pop into the army? What did we lose? We lost a unit of Battle Pilgrims, is what we lost. There'll be a rebellion in 2 turns. So we want to be in there. We want to be moving in there next turn, so we can't really go for another Battle Pilgrim unit. Which is a shame. Yes. Well, unless I move her to Helmgart. No, I'll just move her to Helmgart now, which actually... You seek prophecy. It'll stop that, but let's move her out of Helmgart then. You seek the lady. Still have a rebellion. Oh, no, we want her to replenish though, don't we? Okay, no, we're not going to have a rebellion yet. We're going to sort out our army, then we'll let the rebellion happen. Yes. I'll give her that. That's fine. No rush with it. We could just neutralize by keeping her there, but we don't want to do it forever. In that case, we can set Helmgart to upgrade... For now, I would give you that. We'll have to do that next turn.
King Luan Leoncoeur. A king stands with you.
We get new cavalry for Luan. And down here, we'll get those defences going in 1 and 2 turns, respectively, for each of them. Economy's doing well at the moment. And our enemies are quiet, just gathering back up. We haven't reclaimed the Longship graveyard yet, and I haven't seen anything. I should probably send out like a damsel or something, shouldn't I? To just potentially scout chaos coming in. What do you think? Let me know in the comments section. End the turn. Wood Elves and Crooked Moon have got peace. Okay. Building lots of things. Rowan has upgraded as well. Which is good. Very good. Right, you're gonna get that.
It shall be so. Do you know who I am?
I think we all know who you are.
My strength and wisdom are yours.
Yeah, I kinda think we need to get you an army, don't we? Actually, it might be better for Alberic to deal with the rebellion than that spawns over here. Possibly. Also got a rebellion coming at Carcassonne. If we don't do something about that quick. Tabarro, there you go. Next time we'll do the same over there. Well, actually, over here, we can just set your provincial effect, because we're not doing any up. Well, we will do building, but not right now, so let's throw that over there. That'll keep everyone happy for a bit. Same at Padovan. Yeah, let's just make you happy with that. You guys are alright. We still need to sort out Artois, actually.
Luan Leoncoeur.
Clever.
The lion.
I think after this we'll be sending both Luan and Shilfori north, unless chaos appears on the doorstep between now and then. But we do have the Fae Enchantress to hold. Yeah, we want questing knights. Wow, look at that, rank 9. Yeah, it's because of the bonus, you know, experience plus this region anyway, so it's all good. So we can get elite cavalry for him. I mean, in a way we could almost consider, would it be worth replacing the Knights of the Realm, for instance, rank 9 as well. That makes those questing knights very, very nice, but we can't afford them this turn, so we will have to wait.
King of Bretonnia.
Federation between the Empire and Ostermark. The unification of Bretonnia is done. That should help our relations with the Empire and what have you further. I guess I might ally with the Empire against Chaos. Right, now we've done all that. Safer Woods, Beastmen. I think we're just going to go for some economic bonuses and buffs and things like that right now. Water Pump seems like a pretty good one to get. Irrigation ditch upkeep for infantry. That's quite nice. Let's go for improved agricultural tools then first. Although we also want to get the harbour master bribes. Are you gaining? Yes, you are gaining a bit of experience each turn, aren't you? Die maker. No. We want to get 2 questing knights from here.
You seek me?
Okay. Now we want Helmgart to rebel. So over here. So 4 turns, which should give her enough time to fully replenish her whole army. And then, yeah, we can deal with that finally. Finally. Tabarro, you get defences as well. We can upgrade those straight away from there. I think now Estalia is much more solidified. Strength and garrison wise, so that's all good. You chill there. You guys are replenishing. How many more turns? 3 turns before we can send you back on another raid. I mean, we could swap out your infantry, but I think for now we'll keep them as they are. And we I mean, to be fair, we've got the money. We could push it. We could push it to foot squires. Again, feel free to weigh in. My war council. Chat council, I guess. War council. Sembol. To upgrade Bastogne so we can upgrade this to legitimately get more foot squires. We also need to upgrade this. Chivalries, we're about to hit another level, I think, so that'll be another Green Knight token. I haven't had to use him once yet. I mean, there's been an opportunity where we could have probably used him. Things just worked out in our favour. The Bray Herds come. Oh, they're up there. Infrastructure, cost for all buildings, or the future, growth. Construction cost for things that I'm doing now. I am doing a lot of building at the moment. More growth. I can't think of anywhere. Well, more 20% construction cost would allow me to do more right now. I'm going to go for distribute it now. So is that the Jagged Horn? No, the Red Horn tribe have popped up. We're at war with the Jagged Horn tribe, although I don't know where they are. Yeah, how strong are we? Are we one? Yeah, we are strength rank one. Let's sort them by strength rank. So haven't met who's ever strength rank two, so I imagine that's the Greenskins or the Dwarves, depending on who is killing who faster there. Then it's the Varg, then it's the Warriors of Chaos. Osland Empire. Elf scaling. Alright, it's the only one that likes me that I don't have trade with. No, not really. Telia, you're unfriendly. Your man gods. Well, you're also a man, are you not? Yeah, they're nearly fully replenished. We've got a very healthy income. We could probably give Albrecht an army and send him off. Ah, no, the Red Horn down here. There we go. Gordos. I'm going to set you to upgrade. You've already got walls, though. This will just give you more. Should be more than enough to hold them, I imagine, with 15. Magritta, you should be able to hold that back. Ports. Well, let's upgrade. Tabari's over there. You're garrison, actually. Your ballet. Yeah, you might be in trouble then. You'll have walls. Can't even. I mean, I could pop a lord in there to try and help. Otherwise, I'm going to have to back travel a fair bit here. Although there, oh no, it depends if they've got minotaurs. They might be able to just smash right in, or a Saigor until they've spawned in. A lord to try and help. I'm not sure we can hold them all back, though. That's the only problem. Lords don't add anything, though, so I might as well pop one in. Melee attack. You're a good lord, though. Bonus versus large, that actually might be rather good. You're level 8 though, so you should be stronger. Yeah, we'll pop you in then. Protector of the realm. My strength and wisdom are yours. And of course everything went through this rather than giving you some more units. I will indulge. The vain hope that they don't attack me this turn. Let's just throw some archers in there. We can always disband them next turn if the garrison finishes. If not, we may send Lyon down there. Warrior King. Or we can send the Fey Enchantress down now, just in case. She's close, and then it would be up to Lyon to deal with the Helmgut Rebellion. Yeah, we'll do it that way then. Just in case. Blessings of the lady. Rick, you're slowly getting there, buddy. Slowly getting there. The thing is, you've got to get Root Marcher first. Oh, look, the scaling coming. I might start building you an army, I think. Although, actually, looking... Oh, wait, no. Well, the peasant economy, we can afford a hit, can't we? But we've also got to factor in the cost of units. You can get a fair, nice bit of cavalry. You can get some questing knights. I think we'll go for a fair few of them.
Do you know who I am?
And we can just go for the basic infantry. Can't actually get the foot knights yet. But squires, actually, not foot knights. You just sort out Artois. Right, let's end the turn and see what happens. See what occurs. Hello, Crooked Moon. Scaling coming in. Oh, Ambusher, Findle. Hello, Poppet. Oh, yeah, you're... Oh, that's where they've gone, the Jagged Horn Tribe. Okay. Well, they didn't attack me, so that's good. You're actually just raiding at the moment.
My reputation precedes me.
So, with those in place, I'm pretty confident we don't need the extra archers anymore. Might leave that Lord there, though. We will set that to upgrade straight away, because, yes. We won't upgrade the port just yet, though, just in case it goes. Carcassonne is a bit of a target, so, yeah, we'll continue bringing the Fae Enchantress down.
I will come to your aid. You seek the lady?
And we've got you're going to rebel in two turns. So, Luan.
I ride.
Let us force march you to Montfort. A little bit of extra replenishment. Shilfroy is a turn away from being fully healed, but I imagine they're going straight for Marienburg. We need to build walls at defences at Marienburg. We can actually do that. We just need enough money to do so. Although this turn, I'm probably going to be upgrading things for for Koron. Alright, the lady. Look at that on its building reduction, that's good. Artois. Oh well, yeah, chaos is really creeping up here. We need to boost this up a bit. Sort that over to the venerate the lady a bit, because we don't need to build anything just yet. Ritta, you guys will hold. Chaos is building. Rising. We need to build a Grail shrine in most provincial capitals, I think. They're struggling. End the episode after this in turn to see what the scaling do. Imagine they're going towards Marienburg.
I am King Leoncourt.
You want a military alliance? Or payment? You don't get on with the Empire, so... I mean, I could use that to crush the Empire, but I'm not going to tie myself down. I'm going to tie myself down. Don't want to commit. Non-committal. It's the Bretonian way, right? Rebellion imminent.
I am the blood of Gilles.
So I can't move you into the settlement, otherwise that will stop the rebellion.
King Lewin.
That will still trigger the rebellion, and you're close enough to reinforce when it gets attacked. Or has gained a rank. What are we going for you? We can't get your hippogriff yet. Go for questing Val, but you don't have any questing knights yet. I know we could swap some out, but we won't do that just yet. We will go for Glorfinial's Prodigy.
Yes. Yes.
I'm fully expecting you to be attacked, and then Shilfroy can be like, surprise! In fact, Shilfroy... move to here.
Do you know who I am?
So you can be like, spread. money. Need a little bit more. Next turn. Oh, if we swap that over from growth to that, then we could afford it. Yeah, we want to get Bastogne upgraded now. You can now attack them.
My reputation precedes me.
Oh, we're not. Well, we're not at war with you. That's why. I didn't need, that's why I didn't attack me. I didn't need to panic. Didn't even look at that. I wonder how many of you picked that up. Well, There we go, isn't it? I panic. I see beastmen and go, ah! I'm surprised we're not instantly at war with them. Because you're just going through and raiding my land. So, yeah, I don't really want that. Yes, die. Could you not? Is the question. Could you not? Well, we're going to wrap up here. I think I'll fight this one just to give round two a go with these Battle Pilgrims and everything else and the Questing Knights from last time. So I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Take pride in the Legion. Check out my affiliates and sponsors, XMG, Green Man Gaming, and Overclockers UK. Until the next one, ciao for now.